If you live in North Carolina, you are well aware of the current battle between the Treasurer of North Carolina, the State Employees Health Plan, and the medical community. If you don't live here, you only need to read about it in this month's Modern Healthcare. But you still should pay attention to it because this could happen in your state. Simply put, what's happening is the Treasurer of North Carolina has decided that he needs to save money that the State Employees Health Plan is spending too much money. I completely understand that. Health insurance is a massive part of any employer's budget, and the state is no different than that. So he decided that the best way to save money was to pursue a policy called reference-based pricing. Simply put, he put out new contracts to all providers with the same rates no matter what provider you are. Everybody's going to get paid the same. Pediatricians, neurosurgeons are all going to get paid the same for the same office visit, hospitals, etc. And basically what he said is if you don't sign this contract by July 1st, you will not be in network for the 700,000 state employees, teachers, state employees, etc. That started the fight. What happened? Well, July 1st came and went. And what we know is 3 out of 126 hospitals in the state of North Carolina actually signed the contract. 3 out of 126. Those three hospitals have a combined 212 inpatient beds. Not a very robust network. So what did the treasurer say? He said, well, looks like all these teachers and state employees aren't going to have an in-network hospital in their community, and he blamed the hospital system. Now, I have serious problems with what the treasurer is doing. I don't argue that we need to try to save money. What I'm arguing is I think he's going about it the wrong way. The treasurer's plan, according to his own numbers, will save the state over $300 million, and that's what he's focused on. Here are my issues with what he's doing. First of all, where's that money going to come from? All he's doing is basically saying that I'm going to lower what I pay for these services. Well, that's an expense reduction for the state, but every expense reduction is a revenue reduction for somebody else. That's money that was going to pay doctors and hospitals that won't be there. $300 million is like getting rid of 150 doctors. The complete salaries for 150 doctors. Now, I wasn't aware that we had this doctor surplus and that we could afford to get rid of 150 doctors. So again, my first issue is, where are we going to find this money? Where is it coming from? Are we going to provide less care, less quality care? It's a serious question. My second problem is, the treasurer seems to be taking the position that as the largest employer in the state, he should get a better deal. That as the largest employee, he should be able to pay less than other employers pay. Okay, I sort of understand this whole volume purchasing scenario, but what they don't address is this. Does that mean that doctors and hospitals should charge more to smaller employers? Are we trying to establish the position that how much you pay for an office visit or knee surgery or cardiac surgery is dependent on how many employees you have? And if so, what does that do to the small employers? Myself, as a small employer, I provide health insurance for my 7 employees. Should I have to pay a whole lot more than the state? And what's that going to mean to the economy, the folks who generate jobs, and the small employers? Well, I'll tell you what it means if we go down that road. More and more small employers will stop providing insurance. Remember, under 50 employees, there's no penalty under the ACA for not providing insurance to your employees. I don't think that's necessarily a good thing. My final argument with what the treasurer is doing is this idea that everybody should be paid exactly the same. His argument basically is that an office visit provided by a pediatrician should be paid exactly the same as a pediatric neurosurgeon or a pediatric neurologist or a cardiac surgeon or an oncologist, whoever. And again, this is making no disparaging comments against pediatricians. Lord knows I have 3 kids and I've utilized them greatly. The point is, there's a different level of training. There's a different level of cost. There's a different level of overhead, which is why there's typically different reimbursement based on specialty. Think about hospitals perspective. Should a small general hospital be paid exactly the same as a large teaching institution, an academic medical center? Well, that's in essence what the treasurer is saying, is we're going to pay everybody exactly the same. We're going to reference-based price this. Now, I find this interesting because within the state employees health plan, within state employees, they don't have that approach. I wonder what would happen if we took the teachers and said, you know what, rather than having different pay scales based on how many years you've taught, your experience, or your level of education, a master's degree, a PhD, et cetera, we're just going to pay everybody the same. A teacher is a teacher, right? It's a commodity. I mean, isn't that what we're saying about hospitals and doctors? They're all the same. It's a commodity. I wonder what would happen if we said, we're just going to pay teachers the exact same salary. I'll tell you what happened. Some of the teachers who are early teachers, new into the role, with less education, would get a raise, and they'd be very happy. That's what's happening in this treasurer's program. A lot of primary care physicians are very happy because they're going to get a raise on this program. And our more experienced teachers, our more educated teachers, our teachers with higher level of training would get a huge salary cut. What would they likely do? Teach somewhere else. What it produces is what's called a lowest common denominator scenario. In other words, if we pay everybody the same, we're going to get the same results. We're going to get the same type of person. Same thing would happen in healthcare. And that's what's happening in the treasurer's plan. A lot of primary care physicians are signing up, but more of the high cost, high overhead, highly trained specialists and hospitals aren't. I'll leave you with this. There's an old saying that says, when elephants fight, only the grass gets hurt. And that's what's happening here. The treasurer, the state employees health plan are fighting with hospitals and doctors. Elephants are fighting, and the grass is going to get hurt. And in this case, the grass are teachers and state employees. These are the last people that deserve to be hurt. Their salaries are not great. They do it for a passion and love of what they do. And one of the only things that was a positive of their job was the benefit package. And now what we're going to say to those hardworking teachers and state employees is, oh, and now your benefit package stinks because you're not going to have a hospital in your network. You're not going to have the specialist that you need when you get really sick. So I would ask the treasurer, think about what you're doing. Your idea of trying to save money or your desire to save money is not a bad one. You're just going about it the wrong way. Thank you.